A suspected teenage serial burglar will be prosecuted as an adult. Caleb Petrick faces charges that could put him in prison for decades. He is a suspect in at least a half dozen home break-ins spanning Douglas and Sarpy counties dating back more than a month. KETV NewsWatch Evans' Ryan Luby is breaking new ground on the story at 5. Ryan, prosecutors today told you that Petrick failed the system and himself?
Yeah, pretty much. And even though he's here at the Douglas County Youth Center tonight in custody, he will go to court tomorrow as an adult. And one of Douglas County's top prosecutors says that Petrick's been given the chance time and time again to make up for his mistakes, but he simply has not.
Dealt with. And when you're going to do adult behavior, you're going to be treated like an adult.
That's the simple philosophy from Chief Deputy County Attorney Brenda Beadle in Douglas County.
And besides his history and his age is the serious nature of these events. We're not talking about shoplifting.
She says we're talking about burglary. In the latest and last case, police say they found Caleb Petrick in the basement of this home near 53rd and P Monday morning, brandishing a pitchfork he used to break in. And after the homeowner says Petrick ransacked the place.
Piggy man was just on the floor and
rifling through whatever he could. Petrick, who's been in trouble since he was just 13 years old, arrested in 2007 for criminal mischief and drugs, caught running from home in 2008 while on probation, caught running again in 2009 after cutting off his monitoring bracelet, sent to the youth rehab facility in Kearney after that, then busted for drugs in 2011 and put on a monitoring bracelet yet again, which he removed yet again. Brenda Beadle says juvenile rehab is no longer an option. It's not punishment. She says Petrick's had his chance to make up for his mistakes, but failed every time.
Well, I think he's been afforded the services, and he didn't take advantage of that. Obviously, he chooses to continue to make these bad choices, and now he's going to have to be dealing with them on an adult level.
Now, Petrick will go before a judge in Douglas County tomorrow morning right at 9 o'clock. Rob?
And Ryan, I know you spoke off camera with Petrick's father. What did he have to say this morning?
Yeah, all he'd tell me was that his son was a good kid until all of these things started to happen just in the last couple of years. Rob?
All right, Ryan, we'll keep following this. Thank you very much.